Hi, my name is Dr. Deborah Setter. Welcome to my Peripheral Neuroanatomy course. This video covers the advanced neuroanatomy of the leg. There aren't too many extra muscles that you need to know, so this video will be short. We have already covered the exam maneuvers for the leg in the foundational and intermediate videos. If you want a comprehensive list of all of the muscles of the leg, you can reference the Excel spreadsheet online. I'm leaving out several muscles that cannot be tested bedside or on EMG because I want to keep this information clinically relevant. Let's get started.
All right, now let's draw the complete peripheral neuroanatomy of the leg. Again, focusing on what is clinically relevant. We'll start again with our nerve roots, L2, L3, L4, L5, S1, S2. Then remembering that those come together and form the lumbosacral plexus. And then we have our nerve branches. Our femoral nerve gets contributions from L2, L3, and L4. The obturator nerve gets contributions from L2, L3, and L4. The superior gluteal nerve gets contributions from L4, L5, and S1. Then our sciatic nerve, L4, 5, 1, and 2 combine to form the sciatic. And our sciatic nerve is actually two nerves in one. Our tibial nerve, which branches into the medial plantar and the lateral plantar. And we need a little extra room. The fibular nerve, which has its superficial and deep branches. We'll also add in L5, S1, and S2. This is our inferior gluteal nerve. Okay, now let's add our muscles. The femoral nerve innervates the iliopsoas, which is actually three muscles, the iliacus, psoas major, and psoas minor. The femoral nerve innervates the quadriceps, which is our rectus femoris, vastus lateralis, intermedius, and medialis, and then our sartorius muscle. The obturator nerve innervates the thigh adductors, which is the adductor longus, adductor brevis, and the adductor magnus, as well as the gracilis and the obturator externus muscles. The superior gluteal nerve innervates the gluteus medius, gluteus minimus, and the TFL, tensor fasciae latae. The inferior gluteal innervates the gluteus maximus. The sciatic nerve innervates the semimembranosus and the semitendinosus portions of the hamstrings. Then the tibial portion innervates the long head of biceps, and the fibular nerve innervates the short head of biceps. I forgot to draw here that the tibial and fibular nerves combine to form the sural sensory nerve. The tibial nerve is going to innervate the gastrocnemius, soleus, posterior tibialis, flexor hallucis longus, and flexor digitorum longus. The medial plantar branch innervates the abductor hallucis, and then the lateral plantar branch innervates the abductor digiti minimi in the foot, as well as the interossei in the foot. The superficial branch of the fibular nerve innervates the fibularis longus and the fibularis brevis. And the deep branch innervates the anterior tibialis, fibularis tertius, and then the extensor hallucis longus, extensor digitorum longus, and extensor digitorum brevis. And there you go. There you go. This is the advanced peripheral neuroanatomy of the leg.
All right, now we've updated that diagram of the peripheral neuroanatomy of the leg. Let's go through the table. Again, I encourage you to take handwritten notes. I'm only going to present the new muscles here, so combine this information with the intermediate leg table to have a complete table. Feel free to reorganize the information in the way that makes sense to you. Download this PowerPoint to quiz yourself. And I've pared down the list of muscles primarily for those that we care about for our neuromuscular exam and for EMG purposes. There are many additional muscles in the leg, so I've compiled an Excel sheet with the complete anatomy that you can use as a reference. For my table, I'm listing it by the muscle, then the nerve that supplies the muscle, and the root that comprises that nerve, and I have this grouped by nerve. First, for the iliopsoas muscle, know that this is comprised of three muscles, the iliacus, psoas major, and psoas minor. All of these are supplied by the femoral nerve and the L2-3-4 nerve roots, primarily L2 and 3. Next is the sartorius muscle, supplied by the femoral nerve, L2-3-4 nerve roots. The thigh adductors is comprised of the adductor longus, brevis, and magnus, as well as the gracilis and the obturator externus. These are all innervated by the obturator nerve, primarily L2, 3, and 4. The adductor magnus can have some L5 innervation. The interossei pedis, the dorsal aspect, these are innervated by the tibial nerve, lateral plantar branch, S1 and S2. And that's it. Thank you so much for your attention.